The September 1st to 4th meeting in Samoa ended with $1.9 billion pledged in sustainable development partnerships and the commitment of participants to work together in the areas of sustainable economic development, climate change and disaster risk management, social development, sustainable energy, ocean health and water and sanitation, food security and waste management. Thursday's meeting was the first step in devising the local strategy to do that.
The purpose of this meeting is to take a look at what came out of Samoa to try to figure out how what the international community is saying fits with our own development challenges and to explore opportunities for synergies and to engage St. Lucian civil society in helping to move that agenda forward. The second objective of this meeting is to create what we are calling a civil society coalition for sustainable development.
40 organizations responded to the invitation to today's meeting to determine the shape of the proposed broad-based alliance of government, civil society and the private sector.
One of the challenges in St. Lucia, both for the government and I think for organizations like mine, multilateral agencies, is the lack of cohesion, cohesiveness among civil society organizations. There are a lot of them working in St. Lucia, but there's no kind of framework to bring them together to articulate their needs, to articulate on issues. And therefore, this conference today, this workshop today, will facilitate that transition and bring in civil society organization one step forward, closer to creating a national coalition.
The aim is to ultimately come up with a vision plan for addressing the unique development challenges faced by small island developing states like St. Lucia, one that gives civil society a more meaningful role in helping to achieve the essential requirements for sustainable development.